few weeks ago, I decided it was time to watch Saving Private Ryan with my 12-year-old son. He's at an age where he's heard a lot about what happened to my father and his grandfather, but not enough about the brave men and women of the Allied forces who sacrificed so much so that Hitler's empire could be crushed. We watched the first 10 minutes, and as with every time I watched that opening sequence, the tears came as I knew they would, and I experienced that recurring sense of gratitude, so thick, a personal gratitude for my life and for that of my family that it could almost suffocate. My father felt that gratitude to his core. In fact, the only time I can ever remember my father truly angry with me was when once in college I tried to argue over the dinner table that burning the flag should be protected free speech. Do you, his words cutting and for once not caring, have any idea what that flag means to the soldiers who fought their way to liberate me? And do you know what it means to me? And 25 years later, I asked my son, after the on-screen fighting has died down, after Tom Hanks has been given his mission, and after I have recovered, I asked him, do you have any questions? And he turns to me and he says, does that really happen? That so many men would fight to rescue one? And that question, I believe, is at the core of tonight's event. And it touches the Force family, it touches the Netanyahu family, and my own. Yoni Netanyahu was decorated twice for rescuing fellow soldiers who lay wounded deep behind enemy lines. First in the Golan Heights in the Six-Day War, 1967, and then again in the Yom Kippur War of 1973. In this, he epitomized the Israeli ethos that every soldier was a son, a brother, a father, a husband, and had infinite value. Only in understanding the intimate nature of Israeli society and the value that Judaism places on life can outsiders hope to understand how Israeli governments go through the brutal business of trading hundreds of terrorist prisoners for just one Israeli soldier, alive or dead, so that families can find closure. And Yoni fought for those held captive, ultimately leading Operation Entebbe, renaming Tzvei Yonatan in his honor, to rescue over 100 hostages on that fateful night in 1976. Yoni and my father encountered each other, not in the physical world, but through the pages of a book. Yoni writes in his letters, the town beyond the wall held me spellbound. I got it one day in June 1967, wounded in a hospital. The hospital people were distributing books to the wounded, and by stroke of fortune, I got this one. I lose myself in it, but no, I don't lose myself. It's just the opposite. I find myself richer, cleaner, stronger. There is one character in this book who looms above the others, Pedro, a Spanish Christian, who challenges and debates the main character, a Holocaust survivor, on all manner of issues. And in the same way that is Francois Mauriac, a Catholic who tells my father that he must write and share his story, it is Pedro who tells Michael and tasks him, the Christian tasking the Jew, you must help others. Taylor Force felt that sense of mission, serving for 9 months in Iraq and 12 months in Afghanistan. And rather than being remembered for his classified military objectives, he is instead remembered for the most powerful gift he could ever give to the families of the soldiers who served under his watch. He is remembered for his perfect record of having never suffered a loss on his team. That does not happen by accident, and it does not happen without the passion for one's men. During Taylor's service, Stuart and Robbi Force retired so that they could be together. Their deepest fear was that they would see the black car pulling up or receive the call from the Defense Department, and that they would not be together to support each other through the pain. Can you imagine those 2 years of anxious nights? And then they experienced the profound relief of his service being over. Taylor, a business student now, would travel to Israel. He was inspired to visit not only for the chance to engage with the future of industry he saw taking shape there, but he felt compelled from having personally visited the despair at Auschwitz and having personally experienced Jewish hope at his best friend's traditional wedding. And when Taylor's life was so tragically taken exactly 2 years ago, it was time to assemble a rescuing army of a different sort. Because what Stuart, Robbi, and Kristen Force have done is nothing less than that, the assembling of a rescuing army. They have assembled an army to rescue meaning out of this brutal circumstance and to do that work in their son's name, keeping alive their son's commitment to others and doing their part to ensure that American taxpayers will no longer send dollars to fund the death of innocents. Yoni Netanyahu's father, Ben Sion Netanyahu, commented in 1977 that Yoni would have been disappointed by the West's tolerance of terrorism. I quote, "He would, I think, express great dismay and concern at the weakness and indecision displayed by some democracies towards the phenomenon of terrorism. He felt that there are principles that must be upheld if civilization itself is to survive." End quote. There can be no moral ambiguity in the Force family's insistence that we stop paying $400 million a year to allow the nightmare of a young wife holding back a door with her body to protect her five young children while her husband is stabbed to death over the Shabbat dinner table. The nightmare of parents watching terrorists celebrating the murder of their son with dancing and sweets. Friends, this is what it means to find meaning in life and in death. This is what it means for Yoni Netanyahu and Taylor Force to take their place in history. And before I close, I want to talk to you about my family and how we too are grounded in that history. My cousin Steve is my personal hero. He shares my name. We are both named Shlomo after my grandfather. Steve led the surgical team in Israel's air rescue unit for many years, flying into dangerous territory on helicopters to extract and operate on stranded soldiers or pilots. His career, as well, is an answer to my son's question about whether the many in this day and age truly risk themselves to rescue the few. And in doing so, he is deeply connected to our familial memory. Last week for the holiday Purim, he flew to Siget, my father's hometown, and he managed to get the old synagogue open. And he managed to find enough Jews so that he could read the Megillah, the story of Esther. And I want you to listen to what he read in this ghost town of Jews that had gone from 10,000 to only a handful. He read from the end of the Megillah, and the Jews had been granted the right to self-defense. It was granted to the Jews that in every city to gather themselves to death together and to stand for their lives. And now listen to what Yoni Netanyahu wrote in 1973. "I don't intend to tell my grandchildren about the Jewish state in the 20th century as a mere brief and transient episode in thousands of years of wandering. I intend to hold on here with all my might. To stand for our lives, to have a homeland so that the Jews might never again face genocide, to stand for the value of life, to celebrate life rather than death." Shortly after writing The Town Beyond the Wall, the book that Yoni read, my father as well returned to Syria in 1984 for his own confrontation with the past. His grandfather, Eliezer, had died before he could know him. He had been a medic in the First World War, who'd also died trying to save others. My father wrote, "An extraordinary serenity dwelt in the graveyard. And I spoke quietly to my grandfather, and I told him what I had done with his name. Yoni, do you know how many countless sons of Israel have been named after you? Do you know what your name means to the nation you love so much? Taylor, do you look down and see how your family was not content to let your good works end before their time, how your name has become a blessing? And grandfather, do you feel your name being continued by my dear cousin, who never hesitates to tell me that what he does in my name too. And let me close with a blessing I know my father felt every day through his life. And God bless the United States of America and the State of Israel and all those, living and dead, who wear and have worn the uniform to protect their values and defend innocent life. Please join me in honoring the memories of Yoni Netanyahu and